Hello, I'm Phil English. I'm the National Coordinator for the Healthcare Group Purchasing Industry Initiative, and we are here to release our 15th annual report, our most important report ever, not only because it's a 15-year milestone of annual reports on conditions within the healthcare supply chain, but also because it provides the first window yet for policymakers those who are involved in the healthcare system of what is going on in the supply chain. Our survey continues to be the most comprehensive survey of the healthcare supply chain, of ethics and best practices, and also, as a practical matter, what is going on. What we've seen over the course of the last year is that healthcare group purchasing organizations have played a critical role in addressing problems within the supply chain, have provided critical vetting of gray market suppliers who are new into the market, and many of them of questionable provenance and reliability. They have loaned expertise to federal and state officials as they have moved supplies within the supply chain and manage stockpiles. They have also developed new information technology applications that have made the healthcare system stronger in the face of the pandemic. Healthcare GPOs have also provided identification of drug shortages where they have occurred, and our finding is that they have identified critical supply chain disruptions. In the aftermath of the pandemic, we are anticipating permanent changes in the healthcare supply chain and necessary reforms would strengthen the resiliency of how our products get to healthcare suppliers in a manner that provides transparency and cost controls. We are also anticipating that GPOs are going to continue to play a critical role in the introduction of new technology into the healthcare marketplace, in promoting diversity within the healthcare supply chain, and also promoting sustainability of healthcare products and services. This institutional expertise has been valuable during the course of the pandemic crisis, but it's also going to be in the long term a source of institutional memory and also an important resource in the avoidance of some of the mistakes that we have seen within the pandemic. HGPII is going to continue its mission, providing oversight, providing advocacy of best practices through a comparative process, and also a verification that best practices are occurring within the healthcare supply chain. I anticipate that this year's report is going to be an important addition to the literature of all who are involved in healthcare policy, and is going to lay the groundwork for even more details and insights next year. Thank you for listening.